The global wind energy industry is blowing harder than ever and a key driver in the offshore wind energy market. The United Kingdom generates one-third of the world's 14 gigawatts of offshore wind capacity, followed by Germany, China, Denmark and the Netherlands to round out the top five. Now, China recently moved up to the number three spot, stimulated by government cuts in tariffs. And its goal is to produce 5 gigawatts of energy from coastal projects by 2020. Offshore wind is growing in popularity because it's cleaner than carbon-producing methods. There are faster and more consistent wind speeds offshore than on land. And it can be locally produced, creating jobs that feed the local economy. Well, the U.S. only switched on its first offshore wind farm last month. It now powers a small community of about 1,000 people in the state of Rhode Island. Now, despite wind energy's benefits, there was also concerns in setting up the site. Karina Huber went to the town of Block Island to see what those most directly impacted think.
Block Island, off the coast of Rhode Island, has long been known for its rugged beauty. Surrounded by beaches, rolling hills, and freshwater ponds, it's a top tourist destination. But now it is known for something else, home to America's first offshore wind farm, consisting of 5 turbines capable of powering up to 17,000 homes. Making history wasn't easy. The $300 million project, developed by Deepwater Wind, faced substantial opposition. Environmentalists were worried about the impact on bird species, and some residents weren't happy about the prospect of altered views. Longtime resident Lori McTeague says compromises had to be made.
It's a give and take. You know, if you want to save something, you're going to have to maybe not have the best view.
David Rosa, who has lived on the island for 38 years, says when he looks at the wind farm, he doesn't see an eyesore. He sees progress.
It's nice to go by the power company and not see all the smoke coming out of the stacks and the noise, and I'm sure the neighbors there really appreciate it.
The island used to be powered entirely by diesel fuel, nearly 1 million gallons of it transported every year by ferry.
Before Deepwater Wind, Block Island had among the highest electricity rates in the country. They also had the dirtiest power in the country.
Now the island is powered almost entirely by clean energy. The project was meant to be a prototype to prove offshore wind can be economically viable in the U.S. Its successful launch has potentially changed the landscape for the offshore wind industry.
Offshore wind power is in its infancy stage in the United States, but there are signs it's picking up. In January, another project was approved off the shores of New York's Long Island. That project will have up to 15 turbines capable of powering 50,000 homes, which would make it the biggest offshore wind project in the United States.
But some are concerned about the future of renewables in the U.S. Many projects rely on federal tax incentives, and U.S. President Donald Trump has shown less enthusiasm for renewables than his predecessor. Nevertheless, Jerry Elmer isn't worried.
I think that we will continue to see substantial build-out of renewable resources, and in particular offshore wind, regardless of what the federal administration in Washington does.
He believes states will take the lead in subsidizing projects, as they won't be dropping their mandates to fight climate change. He also expects the price of renewables to continue to fall, which will help the industry grow.
As time goes on, these subsidies from state or federal governments are becoming increasingly less important.
America's first offshore wind farm is small, but its potential is huge. A recent U.S. government report concludes offshore wind could produce about double the amount of electricity currently generated in the U.S. Karina Huber, CGTN, Block Island.